Hey, how's it going? It's your bro here, and I hope your day is going well. And in this video series, I'm going to teach you guys C++ for free. I'm not here to try and sell you some course because I'm your bro and I have your back. My lessons are free, and they always will be. If you want to learn C++, look no further because you're in the right place. Let's get into it. Let's begin by discussing the advantages of C++ over other programming languages. So, C++ is a fast language. In fact, it is great for games, if not the best programming language for games because of its speed. So if you ever want to get into game development, I would highly recommend learning C++ at least at some point. Maybe not as your first language, but eventually you'll want to learn this. So C++ is also portable between different operating systems such as Windows, Mac, and Linux. C++ also supports object-oriented programming. And C++ jobs are in demand. Currently, at least in my geographical location, starting salaries for new C++ developers are starting at least at $60,000 per year, but that also depends on your geographical location as well. And if we talk about the advantages, we also need to discuss the disadvantages of C++ over other languages. So C++ is a difficult language to learn. I would not recommend it for your first language. Now, if you're watching this video and you're trying to decide on what you should learn for your very first programming language, I would recommend a few other things instead of C++, just because C++ is a more difficult language to learn. If you go to my channel, I actually have a few different playlists, and if you're undecided on what you want to learn, I would recommend starting with Python, just because I would say that it's the easiest programming language to learn compared to all the others. And other disadvantages of C++ is the use of pointers, and you'll learn what these are later. Misuse of them may make your system crash. There is no to little security with C++, and there is no garbage collection. But remember that all programming languages have certain advantages and disadvantages. The advantages, I would say, far outweigh the disadvantages. Well, what are the uses of C++? Well, I'm glad you asked. It's used for many popular applications, from web browsers to databases to desktop apps. It's because the language is so fast and efficient that any application that's requiring a lot of processing power, they actually better be using C++ because it's one of the fastest languages. C++ is also used for many game engines, and for example, it's used in Unreal Engine because of its speed. And it's also compatible with many embedded systems for electronic devices and microcontrollers. The C programming language might be better for this, but C++ also has the capability to be used for these embedded systems as well as an option. Now you're probably wondering, hey bro, what do I need to start programming in this language? Well, to answer your question, what I would recommend is downloading an IDE. That's an acronym for Integrated Development Environment. It's basically software that helps us write other software. And there's a few recommendations of mine. You just got to pick one of these. I would probably recommend Microsoft Visual Studio to begin. Otherwise, there's a package for Eclipse for C and C++ developers. Otherwise, there's CodeBlocks, but I think that's a little outdated now. But personally, I prefer Microsoft Visual Studio because you can also use it for C Sharp, and there's some packages you can download for game development, which is pretty cool. So if you guys have no preference, I'll walk you guys through how to download Microsoft Visual Studio. If you have a different IDE in mind, feel free to use that one too. To begin, we need to open up the interwebs. Go to any web browser and double-click it to open up the interwebs. Good, step one is complete. Step two is to go to Google and look this up. Microsoft Visual Studio Code, and then you'll want to look up the community version. And it should be this link here, Visual Studio Community. And we're going to download Visual Studio. And we are going to close out of this because we do not like pop-up ads. And if you're running Windows, you have to open this when done. If you're using Mac, I believe you have to drag this to your applications folder. I'm not a Mac user, so I'm not 100% sure on that. We're going to click yes. And we're going to wait here a while. Click continue. And you're going to have to wait again. Well, you should be brought to a screen such as this one. Scroll down and click these two boxes, Desktop Development with C++, as well as Universal Windows Platform Development. Just so you know, there's other packages you can download as well. You can use Visual Studio Community for C#, Unity, and C++ game development. So keep those in mind. You can always select those two if you want. All right, then we're going to click Install. We don't feel like taking a survey right now, so we're going to click Not Now, and we'll continue waiting. Well, welcome back. We're just going to click this Launch button. Sign in with the Microsoft account, otherwise click Not Now, Maybe Later. All right, so with the development settings, you'll want to go to Visual C++. And then you can choose a color theme. The standard is blue, but if you want to feel like a pretend elite hacker, you can select dark mode. And for now, we will continue without code. Here at the home screen, we'll want to go to the top, File, New, Project. And we'll scroll down to C++ Console App. Click Next. We'll need a project name. Call this whatever you want. I'll call mine Hello YouTube. And you can set a location for your project. I'm going to set it to a folder on my desktop, or you can keep this as the default. It doesn't matter. And you can pick a solution name. A solution is basically like a grouping of projects. Here it says a container for one or more projects. You can just keep it the same if you want. And we're going to click Create. Now let me show you guys where you'd want to create a new C++ file. So go to your Solution Explorer, and for some reason, if you don't have this window or you can't find it, let's just pretend that we close out of it. You'll want to go to the top toolbar, View, Solution Explorer, and you do have the option of moving this around if you prefer this in a different spot. And you'll want to go to Source Files, and there may or may not be a file here already. So this is like a test file, and it's actually right here behind our Solution Explorer, if I can move it. All right, yeah, so this is our test file, and all this does is that it displays the words Hello World, and you can actually run this just by clicking the Screen Play button. And if you did have that file, a small console window that says Hello World should appear. However, you might have a different color scheme because I've changed this in past tutorials, but at the end of the video, I'll show you guys how we can actually change the color scheme for this as well. All right, so let's say that you don't have this file, helloyoutube.cpp or whatever else you name this. So let's just say that we delete this. So we'll remove it. Now to create a new file, go to Solution Explorer, Source Files, right click, Add, New Item, then click C++ File. Then next you'll need a name for this. I think I'll just call this Main, that works. Then click Add. All right, let me shift some things around. Why is this so difficult? Okay, this should be good enough. So I zoomed in a little bit. If you want to zoom in on your code, you can go to the bottom left of the window and you can change it here. I think 250 is a good amount for this video at least. All right, so we have a blank C++ file. Let's create a program where we display text to the console window. Well, now you should have a blank C++ file if you want to create a program to display some text to that console window like we did before. This is what you're going to type at the top. A hashtag, like it's a Twitter hashtag. Type in the word include, less than sign, greater than sign, and within these two symbols type IO stream. What we just typed, this is a header file library. It lets us work with input and output. Next, hit enter to go down one or two lines, it doesn't matter. And then we're going to type int main parentheses, then a set of curly brackets. So what this is the main method. So this is the entrance point to our program. And when we run the program, it's going to execute any code within the main method from the top, and it's going to work its way down. Now let's say that you want to display some output to the console window. This is what you type. Type in STD, and that is short for standard, and I'm not referring to sexually transmitted diseases. Then you need a set of colons, then type in COUT, which is short for output. And when you combine these both together, it means standard output. Then next, you need a set of less than signs. This passes information to our standard output to display to the console window. And then next, you can type in some text to display to that console window simply by putting it within a set of double quotes. So here you can type in the typical hello world, but I like to be different on this channel and I'll type something else. So for your project, why don't you type in some lyrics to a song you like and then post it in the comments down below because I would like to read it. So for one song that I like, I'm going to type in this. And then finish everything off with a semicolon. All right, let's run the program. Yep, and here are the lyrics. However, everything here is kind of compressed. You can actually add a new line to the end of this so it gives you some more room. So we're going to go back to our code to do that. So if you want to add a new line, just type in backslash n, and that is a new line character. So let's rerun this. Here's the lyrics that we had before, plus it added a new line after our lyrics, which we intended. So if you're annoyed by having your code on a separate panel or window, you can just drag and drop these. So it's all like on the same window then, so it's a little bit more convenient to work with. All right, so next, let's say that you want to add a second line of text. Well, you just type in the same thing, basically. So std, two colons, c out, two sets of less than signs, and then if you want to type in some words like lyrics, you just put it within a set of double quotes. So I'll type in the next line for this set of lyrics. And then we have the option of finishing this off with a new line. And then don't forget that semicolon at the end. All right, so let's run this. And here's the results. It says, never gonna give you up, never gonna let you down. So you can have multiple lines to display output if you so wish. And in the next video, we'll be discussing more on how we can display output. So before we wrap up this video, let me show you guys a few tricks that we can use to change the color scheme of the IDE, as well as the text and the color of the console window. So let's say that you don't like your current IDE color theme. Let's say that you don't like this dark theme. I don't know why you wouldn't. If you want to change it, go to Tools, Options, and then you can change it here. You could go to, let's say, Blue, then hit OK, and this should change the color scheme. But that is very hard in the eyes, but some people might prefer this and they prefer to be blinded. But I'm going to go back to dark because I am a pretend elite hacker. If you want to zoom in or out of your code, you can change that here in the bottom left corner of your window. You can either pick one of these few settings or you can type in a number that you like. I think 250 for me is a good amount. So lastly, you can change the color scheme of the console window that displays, more specifically this one. I think the default is white text on black background if you want to change that. Actually, I already changed mine, but if you want to change it, click the top left corner, then go to properties, and then here you can change the font size, you can change the cursor size, the layout of the window size, the colors. Actually, let me pick a new font. That's close enough. All right. And then you can change the colors here. You could have like green on green background, which I would not recommend. I think I'll stick with the green text on black background. Oh, I guess you can also change the opacity. Ooh, that's kind of neat. Woo, woo, woo. And then just click OK with any of your changes. And you can see that I changed the font style slightly. So that's how you can change the appearance of your console window. So that will conclude this introduction to C++. In the next video, we will get more in depth with displaying output and eliminating some redundancies that we have here. I'll explain how that works in the next video, but I'll also include some useful links in the description down below. So this video was very exhausting to make. Feel free to smash that like button and drop a comment down below. But yeah, that is everything you need to know to get started programming in C++. Hey you, if you enjoyed this lesson, then you can help me help you in three easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.